Welcome to the Glow Getters Podcast. My name is Kayla Fahey-Arndt, and I'm your host. I teach and inspire leaders to step into their productive selves and find their true potential. I'm a passionate creative and scientist with over 8 years of healthcare leadership experience. At age 25, I stepped into my first management role and didn't find the leadership advice I was looking for. So here I'm giving you the tools to end burnout and enjoy a vibrant career and life. Glad you're here to learn and grow with me. Now, on with the show. Hey, hey, Glow Getters Podcast listeners. Welcome to episode 101. If you haven't tuned in to episode 100 yet, definitely check it out. It dropped this week, and I shared the 10 top leadership learnings I've had in the making of this podcast. And it was so fun to think of the 10 things. And in the show notes and on my website at glowgetterslife.com, and then under the blog, under the title of the episode, I have links to different old podcasts that I've done, you know, demonstrating those lessons. So definitely check it out if you haven't already. But today I want to talk about something different. I want to talk about healthy productivity and what that actually means, because it's a concept I've been thinking about a lot lately. But first, I want to have my own desperation moment. If you haven't left a rating or review yet, I would totally appreciate it. I know there's lots of you that listen, and I would love to get your feedback and also be able to thank you on the air. And so if you leave a review, I will check it out and, you know, mention you, name drop you here on the pod, and tell you to send me a message or email me so that I can send you some freebies. So yeah, please leave me a rating or review, especially on Apple iTunes. And that those are the ones I can actually see and check out. So there you go. That's my desperation moment. So on to today's topic, healthy productivity. I thought it was a good theme, being that this podcast drops on a Friday. And Fridays can feel like a good reminder that we're always working for the weekend or something like that. Like, just need to make it through one more day. Like, let's just get this done. So, healthy productivity. Here's the thing. When people think about productivity, it has sort of like a negative connotation almost. Like, the idea of being productive feels like a lot of work. Or like, if someone says, I'm being productive, it's like, oh, well, they're grinding or they're hustling. And I think, obviously, there's a time and place for that, and I say that all the time. But I think mostly healthy productivity doesn't look like that. And I have a few characteristics of what it does look like and what it doesn't feel like. So let me just run down the list. So healthy productivity means that you're not addicted to working. So if you are working on something and say you like try to stop working and put that work away, if you're unable to do that and you find yourself like reopening your email or refreshing a website or just like, let me do one more thing, that's like a being addicted to your work. You might not think that you are, because addicted feels like a strong word, but if you have like a compulsion to keep working on the thing, then that is what I'm calling an addiction to working. Now, this is so much different than being drawn to something and excited about working on something. This is more like I need to control the situation. I'm maybe anxious subliminally, or I don't realize it, but I need to like constantly be in check, and like I can't put the work down, and it feels like I'm always behind maybe, or it feels like I just need to like get one more thing, and so I'm just going to keep working. Number two, healthy productivity means that when you make an intentional focus about something that you're going to work on, that you actually accomplish that. So, for example, I talk a lot about time blocking and using your calendar to work on strategic goals and be very intentional with the bite-sized work that you do. And so healthy productivity looks like setting aside that time and then being so focused and aligned with the decision you've made, with that intentionality, that during that time you are focused and you do accomplish your work Oftentimes, when we're not in a state of healthy productivity, we feel scattered and we're not very focused, and we have a hard time sitting down and we start working on a bunch of different things. It's kind of the idea that you have like your email open and like a bunch of different tabs, and you said you were going to work on XYZ, but really you're just working on like all the other things, and it's sort of all over the place. When you're in a state of healthy productivity, essentially, you're trusting the plan that you've made and the intentions that you've set. And so you're very focused, and it almost feels easy. You're like, okay, I'm going to sit down and do this thing, and you get it done. The third thing I think of when I think of healthy productivity is that the work you did moves your work forward. So therefore, you know that you had that right intention. And this applies even if you fail. Or like something doesn't work because you've learned something and you've learned the next way to move forward. So basically what I'm saying is that intention that you set on your calendar, that you time blocked, that you were focused for, that work moves you forward in your bigger goals and strategies. And so if it does that, then you know that you were focused and it was the right intention. And that's what healthy productivity feels like. It's like, all right, cool. I am taking a step forward. I am, laying a foundation for the next thing that I have to do. Oftentimes, unhealthy productivity looks like I did a bunch of things and I don't feel like it helped me at all. I still feel behind, or I still feel like I haven't really tackled what I need to tackle. The next thing I think of when I think of healthy productivity is that you find internal gratitude and excitement for what you're doing, instead of seeking applause or praise to stay motivated. So it's that internal motivation that you find where you're like, all right, I am excited to work on this. This feels really good. I'm happy about the work that I'm doing. I can find thankfulness and gratefulness in it rather than like seeking someone to tell you to keep going. So you know that if you're like dreading something or if you do something and you're looking for validation, that doesn't feel so great and it's not like a long-term plan for feeling healthy and not burnt out. And so if you're looking for your boss to tell you like great job on this, work that you did on Monday, then perhaps you're not in that place of healthy productivity. You want to do this work because you find it exciting and find it, find, your own internal gratitude for it. The next thing I think of when I think of healthy productivity is that you come up with new ideas, or you're like constantly thinking about how you can improve or automate or do this work more efficiently. So there's something so fun about being in the flow of doing work, creating, making strategy, implementing. And when you're in that like perfect spot, oftentimes, at least for me, I find myself like, ooh, okay, so like this is working. Like, how do I, automate it so it happens by itself and I don't have to, babysit it? Or, ooh, how do I like implement this across all the other things I'm doing? That sounds like fun. Or, ooh, I wonder like how to like put a Jenga on it, as my colleague and friend Mindy would say, is like, how do I level it up? You just become excited that you're always trying to improve, or you come up with new ideas as you're in the work. When you're burnt out and it's not healthy productivity, usually you're just like doing the work by the skin of your teeth and you just need to get by. You're not actually like creating space for innovation or continuous improvement. And then the last thing I think of when I think of healthy productivity is that you're excited when you sit down to work. So, not every day is going to be like sunshine, rainbows, and butterflies, even for the things that you're excited to work on. But for the most part, when you think about this work that you're going to be doing and you sit down to do it, you should be excited, or at least like, all right, today kind of sucks, but this is sort of my pet project and I really enjoy working on it. So I'm just gonna like make the time. Oftentimes, when we're burnt out or we're not feeling like we're in a healthy space, we're kind of addicted to working, we're not exciting, and we have to push ourselves to sit down and work. We might even have to like mentally prepare ourselves and talk ourselves up to it. You might need to like think about the work for a few days and it's like gnawing at you, and you're like, all right, I just gotta rip the band-aid off and do it. That's what burnout feels like, and that's what it feels like when you're not in a state of healthy productivity. So, if you're not feeling, like you can put the work down and maybe you're feeling a little bit addicted to it, maybe you are not feeling like you accomplish your intentional focus, or that the work didn't move you forward, or maybe you don't find like internal gratitude or motivation, you're looking for others to motivate you. Maybe you have a really hard time like figuring out how to make this better or improving it. You're just trying to get the work done. You're just trying to get by. And maybe that work doesn't excite you. It could be a few different things. It could be that you have alignment issues. So maybe you just consciously or subconsciously don't really feel like this is the right work to be doing. And if that's the case, as you reflect, you want to say, well, what would the right work be, or what would the right work look like? And this would be a good time to pivot. You might actually realize like you're trying to do something that doesn't really feel aligned. That might not be the best thing for you to do. And that's why listening to our gut and our intuition is so important in leadership, because oftentimes you will know if you're doing the right work or not. It could also be a values issue. Is the work that you're doing aligning with your values, or the thing, your morals or ethics or things you find important? Maybe you're finding like, okay, I don't really value this thing and yet I'm working on it. Or maybe I don't really stand by this strategy. Why am I working on it? And I think that would be a good time to think about, is it an ethics, a morals issue? Or maybe it's just like, I don't really understand the why, and it doesn't feel necessary. And that would be a good time to reach out to your boss or whoever you're doing this work for and get some clarification. Because I know for myself, I need to know the why behind stuff. Because if I can't get behind the why, then I have a really hard time understanding. Or finding value, like finding it valuable to use my time to work on that thing. And I know this to be true for other leaders as well, because I have had the experience where maybe I haven't communicated the vision well enough, or people aren't ready to see my vision. And so therefore, they're just not moving at the same pace that I am, and they're finding it difficult to work through that work. And so I know what it feels like from both angles. If you don't feel all of those, healthy productivity feelings that I mentioned, then maybe you are just burnt out, and you need to find some rest, and you need a break. It's totally okay. Sometimes it means taking days off, and sometimes it just means giving yourself space to like let the ideas simmer. And you can keep working in your other work, but maybe like set the one idea aside so that you can come back to it fresh. And also it might just mean that you're just tired and that you've been working a lot of hours, and you need to find some space to get some extra sleep, especially if you are addicted to your work and you're working late hours or spending time after work working on work. It just might mean like put your phone away. There's too much screen time. And so being tired or burnt out or need a break is legit and real. And we're never our best selves when we're not fully rested, or at least as rested as possible. I know a lot of you are parents or caretakers for others, and so maybe a full night's sleep isn't totally possible, but as much rest as you can get, or as little screen time as you need, only as much as you need. You might feel pushed and not a pull to the thing if you're not feeling like you're in a healthy productivity state. And I suppose I could have mentioned it above, but this is sort of like where you're excited to work on it, you're pulled to the work, you're drawn to it versus feeling like you're pushed to it. That might be another sign that like someone else might be pushing you, or you're trying to push yourself rather than you're just drawn to the work. And then The last thing that might be happening if you don't feel like you're in a state of healthy productivity is that maybe you just have like too much work, or you have too much going on, and your energy is spread too thin. And so maybe it's just like there's just a ton of things going on, and you've spread yourself too thin. And that is when it's time to like zoom out and be like, what's important right now, like today? And then what's important this week? And what's important this month? And you'll start to find like there's a lot of things you want to do and feel like you should be doing. And we find shame around not doing everything all at one time because we know what's on our list for like ever. And so that's a good time to pull back and be like, okay, today, what would be important to get done? And if you can do that, then you feel good, and taking action breeds confidence. Confidence breeds more action. Therefore, you're more excited and maybe perhaps a little bit more motivated internally to do that work because you know you can do the things. So I always say, if you're feeling spread too thin, like you have too much work, you probably do. But also, you need to be realistic with yourself and make different priorities based on when things are due. And then, if everything is due all at once, like ask for help and delegate. There's no excuse for just like simmering on work that's not getting done. Like, at some point, there's a threshold where you're like, I just gotta get some extra help. And so, do reach out to your boss, do reach out to colleagues or other people who are working to develop themselves and see what you can offload, because once you do that, you will feel a million times more self-motivated because you know you can handle the work you have. All right, everybody, I hope that that was an interesting concept. I have been thinking about productivity, and I've started to use the word healthy productivity in front of it. And I just wanted to define for you what that meant. And essentially, it means like, you're not feeling like you're addicted. You can set the work down and come back to it, but when you come back to it, you're excited. You're internally motivated. You actually accomplish what your intentional focus was for the day, and that focus moves your work forward, and you come up with new ideas. You have space for innovation and improvement and doing work more efficiently. And you're just, the work feels right. It feels aligned. It feels like what you want to be doing, and you can't wait to do more of it. All right, everybody, I hope that helps. And yeah, thank you again for being around for 101 episodes. And make sure you go back to the archives. They run pretty deep, and there's a lot of cool topics. I find myself scrolling back, like, oh, I forgot about that one, and just like listening whenever I need a little pump up. So, feel free to do that now that we're, 101 episodes deep. And yeah, do let me know what other topics you want to talk about by sending me a message on Instagram at Kayla Fahey Arndt, or leave me a rating and review and put in your review what some additional leadership topics you want to hear about so that I can tackle those for you. All right, everyone, have a wonderful day and take care. And as always, be a light.
All right, that's it for today. Thank you so much for listening, everybody. I wanted to let you know about something new that I'm doing. If you could please leave me a rating and review on iTunes or write in your Apple Podcasts app, I would so appreciate it. Each week, I'm going to be doing a drawing and sending an email to a winner just to say thank you with some treats, tips, and a little bit of extras, because I really want to get this podcast out to more people, and I want to hear how it's helping you, getting feedback about what you'd love to hear about and what you love about the podcast, so I can keep doing that. Also, if you'd like to connect with me on a deeper level, check out my website at glowgetterslife.com. You'll find links to my About Me page so you can learn about me and my journey in leadership. You'll find links to my blog, my podcast for more episodes, and to my YouTube channel. And you can also find links to the templates and leadership planners I've created, as well as my free resource library. All right, thanks so much, and until next time, be a light.